This video is for class BA part 2 English literature, and we'll be discussing a literary term called soliloquy. Actually, soliloquy is a literary term which relates to drama. Literally, it means talking to oneself. In drama, it demonstrates the convention by which a character, when he is alone on the stage, speaks his thoughts aloud. Actually, he is revealing to the audience what is going on in his mind. Thus, we can say the dramatist uses this device as an easy way to convey directly to his audience about a character's motives, intentions, and his state of mind. Sometimes, the playwright also uses soliloquy to convey the general exposition of the play. In Shakespeare's plays, we find a lot of use of soliloquies, especially in his tragedies. One of the best examples of his soliloquies is To Be or Not to Be in his famous tragic play, Hamlet. Macbeth, which we are going to study in your BA part 2, also abounds with soliloquies, in which the protagonist Macbeth reveals his mind in most critical situations. And it will be very interesting to note those soliloquies for the sake of understanding Macbeth's character. I would like to talk one more play, Marlowe's play, Dr. Faustus, which opens with a soliloquy, and it portrays the character of Dr. Faustus very well. And this soliloquy prepares the audience to develop a point of view to look upon Dr. Faustus' basic characteristics. Here, it will be very interesting to discuss a related literary term, which is aside, in which a character speaks in presence of other characters, but he is supposed to speak to himself and no other character is expected to listen to him. Actually, it is a dramatic device to let the audience know secretly what is going on in the mind of a particular character while other characters are present on the stage during a play. Thus, the character addresses directly to the audience in aside. And aside is actually a very interesting term when there are so many characters present on the stage, but the dramatist wants the process of the thoughts of a particular character to be conveyed to the audience directly, which is not supposed to be heard by the other characters present on the stage. And in such a situation, when one character speaks, even when other characters are standing by his side directly to the audience, this particular way of speaking is called aside. Generally, that character puts his hand on his mouth in a way to let the audience know that he is directly speaking to them, to the audience, and not to the characters present on the stage. If we talk about the historicity of soliloquy, it was not a very common feature of Greek or Roman plays. However, in English Elizabethan period drama, soliloquy was used in excess. You will find so many plays where the characters speak soliloquy in order to let the audience know the processing of their minds. However, in modern literature, the use of soliloquy was cut down. It was cut down to very meager use, in favor of demonstrating realism. Actually, the modern playwrights thought that it is absurd to let a character speak on the stage when he is all alone. It does not look real when a single character speaks on the stage to himself, because generally nobody does that. Nobody speaks aloud when he is alone. However, it is an important literary device in which the basic purpose of soliloquy was to let the audience know the process of a character's thoughts and his intentions. Thank you. That's all for today.